Welcome to Onyx Graphics. My name is Don Carey, and I'm a senior software engineer. Today we're going to talk about the Onyx print and cut workflow. Let's take a look at the software. New to Onyx 11 is the Onyx Cutter Manager. In this dialog, you have the ability to disable any cutters that you don't have in your shop, allowing for a simplified display. This dialog also gives you the ability to configure your cutter registration marks that are added automatically at print time. Some cutters allow more control over the placement of marks than others. This cutter, for example, allows you to set the margins around the marks and how much space is in between the intermittent marks. Others require the marks to be placed in an exact location. At the very least, you can choose to turn on and off the Onyx barcode. Once your cutter is configured, you need to tell the RIP what cutter you want to use with your prints. Quicksets provide a great way to manage your workflow, and it's a great idea to create a quickset associated with your cutter. This way, any image opened with your quickset will print with a cutter marked for this cutter, and the cut paths will be generated for your device. In order for the RIP to recognize the cut paths in your artwork, you need to specify a spot color prefix to identify your cut paths. The default is cut contour. You can also automatically generate PDF trim boxes or tile outlines. These are especially useful for automatically cutting out a simple nest of raster images. While quicksets are especially handy for automating workflows, these same options, cutter selection, cut path prefix, and trim boxes, are also available in Job Editor and the Job Options dialog. When you open your job, make sure you have your cutting quickset selected. Once the print is complete, you're ready to cut. In Onyx, this is handled through the Cut Server application. The first step in Cut Server is to select Manage Cutters and add your device. You can add as many devices as you have connected. This icon brings up the Configure Cutter dialog, where you set up your connection port and configure your options. New to Onyx 11 is the ability to manage device settings, cut job settings, and cut layer settings separately, based on whichever your device supports. Device settings, if you have them, apply to every job sent to the device. Cut job settings are configurations that are set once per job. These might include things such as mark recognition strategy, which could change from job to job, but will only be sent once for that job. If your cutter only supports single layer cutting, this is also where you would set pressure and velocity. Layer options allow you to configure different options for multiple cut layers within the same job. An example would be a light pressure and high velocity for a kiss cut, and then a heavy pressure and low velocity for a through cut. Layer options can be automatically matched to the cut layer by giving these settings configurations the same name as the spot layer in the original image. It's a simple process to manually select the layer too. You can add layers, move paths from one layer to another, disable layers, change the cut order, and completely delete a layer and its paths. Once the options and layers are configured, you are ready to cut your job. And that concludes our video on the Onyx print and cut workflow. If you want to learn more, visit our website at onyxgfx.com.